Hello guys, my name is Benz and welcome back to Euro Truck Simulator 2. I got a bit bored on the multiplayer, so I decided to come on the single player and try and change things up a bit and just have a little fiddle with it. And then I decided I'll have another look at some mods. I did look at some mods beforehand. I looked at the pro mods. I looked at I think it was called Tricky Map and Roost Map, and we've done a few videos on that. But I've come back to some more. I don't know what the word is really. Some slightly different mods. Well, I'll start off with this first. I've had a look at the new Pro Mods, which is now integrated with the Scandinavia and the Going East DLC. I'm not gonna say exactly what's new because I'm not 200% sure. I'm just going by what I can see and what looks new. From what I remember, this I can't remember where it's from. These ones are new in France. Those ones are new. That's new. I just noticed that one. Didn't even notice that one. Portsmouth, I'm almost certain it's new. Yeah, because Plymouth was the other one. I always got those two confused in real life for some reason. Plymouth and Portsmouth. But that was a that's the vanilla standard one, whatever you call it. That's the new one. For some reason, you've also got Croydon. I ain't got a fucking clue why you got Croydon on there. I don't know. Well, sorry to anyone who lives in Croydon, but I don't know why that's so significant to have Croydon there. But hey ho. What other ones are new in the UK? Fort William, I'm sure, is new, and Oban, I'm sure. Inverness, I can't remember Inverness. Possibly, I don't know. Oh, hold on. Ah! I didn't even know these ones existed. Okay, so you got. I don't know what that island is. I'm not even going to attempt to know what it is. Awesome. Got those ones, and then you got now Reykjavik is Iceland. Yeah, I'm sure it's Iceland. Yeah, so you got Iceland as well. Bloody hell! And over here you have got what the fuck are they called? Finland. That's it. You got Finland and Estonia. I think that is. Yeah, Estonia. Yeah. And I think you have got some extra ones down here. I'm not 100% sure which ones. I think some new ones in Italy and that. But yeah, so that's Pro Mods. Where ETS2 have come in and put a DLC for all the Scandinavia and then taken over what the Pro Mods are doing. They've gone, right, fuck it, we'll add some more in. So they've, I think Finland was in before, but they've improved Finland and they've added Estonia and they've, well, snuck that one in. Basically. Okay, so. So that's that mod. I've also got a truck mod. When I first started the Euro Truck videos, I can't remember if I put it out or if it's a rush video I never actually put out in the end. But I tried looking at tandem trucks, or in the UK, they're more commonly known as drawbar trailers, or a slang term is wagon and drag. I shall show you what I mean. So if we go to truck dealers, now what make did I want to make? I've already got a couple of these already that I've driven around and tested them out, and I do really like them. There's a few little downsides to the mod, but let's go for what don't I normally have on this channel? I've got an Iveco and a Volvo one, so I want something different. I don't really want a Renault. I ain't got a Scania. I ain't driven a Scania in a while. Let's have a look at a Scania. Oh. Okay, the only Scania dealer I've got is in Estonia, so that works well. That works well. Right, visit sector dealer. Oh, my voice is starting to go already. Excuse me. Right, so if we just go straight on to customized configuration, and I can show you. Fuck it, let's go for the biggest cab we can. Right, so you've got your standard ones, and then you get down to these ones, and then you've got your tandem ones. So if we go, we've got 4x2 tandem. So that's like your standard weight. That could pr the axle weight could probably take. I just noticed the top of the gearbox and all that sticks out the top of the fucking catwalk in the center there. There. This could probably take 18 ton, maybe 24 ton. And then you can move down. I mean, you know, you've got. It does fill in the gaps as well. You do get boxes as well, which is nice. It's a shame what the color is. Are you? I think you can change the color if you're going through the mod. We'll talk about it in a bit. 6x2 tag, tandem. Sorry. So you've got a extra axle, but it isn't the lift axle. It's a fixed axle. I don't know if it's a steered axle. I'm not too sure. There's this one, which is the only one that I've tested with. It's a tag lift, so you go up and down, which is like if you have something this heavy duty, meaning like the cab where you'd be doing long distance, you'd be expected to carry a heavier load. So you would have a big body on the back, which we can put on, and I'll show you that in a minute. But you want extra weight on the axle. You do also sometimes have these ones for more heavy duty ones, which you do in. You know, the Scandinavian countries, you do get they carry logs and that, and you have like the posts up the side here, and they have a trailer as well, which is quite common. But yeah, they would normally have this sort of configuration because that would be a driven axle. That would be, so it'd be driven. So you'd have, so six wheels, four powered, giving more extra traction as well as taking more weight. Tag lift. You can also have the rear axle lifted as well, but that'd be a dead axle. You could take more weight, but you wouldn't have extra traction, wouldn't have extra pull-on power. What else we've got? And then we've got this huge motherfucker. This is for fucking really heavy duty stuff. Sometimes I have seen one before. I think it was on a DAF where you have like a really heavy duty trailer, like a 10 axle trailer, and this would have a fifth wheel on it, so it would be like a standard tractor unit, and you know that's just fucking ridiculous heavy duty, and that's one without a lifting axle, and that's one with a lifting axle. So I can show you the let's just quickly customize it up first, and then I'll show you the body because we're gonna have a Scania. What should we have? Should we have the big fucker? Let's have the big fucker and see how that handles. So I'm gonna go with the tag lift because I like to be able to have an up and down axle. Because with this, I don't know if it's gonna work with this one or not. But you do see like the trailer moving up and down with the air suspension when you pick up a trailer. So we'll have a look at that. Engines. Do I want to go for the big old? I don't want to go for a 7/30. Let's go for like $480, 500. What? Why is that one more expensive then? Or is it because Euro 6? Let's go for a 480 engine, Euro 6. So, latest emission level. Transmission. Go for my retarder, because I've got to have the retarder on. Oh, hold on, what are these ones? Exclusive V8. What's the difference then? Oh, sat nav, cream interior, leather stitched interior. The mirrors are different as well. Why are the mirrors moving? What's wrong? What's the difference in the mirrors? I don't think they've placed the mirrors in exactly the same place as when I included this one. Hey ho, not to bother. Anything else up here? No, just a bit of colour. Let's go with that one. I like that one. I like the like a veneer finish on the steering wheel as well. Let's go with that one. I like that one. That's good. It's good. It's good. Right, stock color. We can change it up at another time, but this is only a test one, so we'll just go for. Actually, with the bot. Let's go crimson around like that a bit. Right, accessories. This is where it can get interesting. Right, so you've got this one here. If we click on this one, because of, I don't know what the fuck that means. You can then have a look at what bodies you want to put on. So you got a standard, you got it's like a curtain side body with like drop down sections along the side. Same along the back. You also get cabinets as well. Do you get cabinets on the? You don't get cabinets on this one. Okay. So next one is just a curtain side body with fixed rear, not fixed rear doors, like opening up doors at the back, but they're not, they're just like heavy duty doors. Cool liner, it's just like a fridge box. Yeah, seal doors at the back. You also then have a, oh, it's not just a firebox, a little firebox. A tanker. This is more common along this sort of, in the UK anyway. This is a more common look along with this sort of setup, not with this axe, obviously. You also then have one. You also have, you can either have one like a chrome finished one, or have one with a sign right on the side of it. You notice all the bodies are the same, company logo on there. It's all Eurotech. It's all like a basic skin on it. If there is, when you download this mod, I'll try and put, remember to put a link in the description because I can't remember where I got this one from. I was a bit of a dickhead, got it and then didn't write it down. It comes with instructions of how to change the skin because the trailers, you have like, I think it's about 10 different trailers to pick from. Like, ranging from what all these look like, and with different axle configurations as well to change the style of the driving. But, it comes with instructions of how to change the skin. I wanted to try and learn how to put, like the Ben 1606 logo on it, but I didn't have time to do it, unfortunately, so we'll have to stick with the standard one. But yeah, it comes with instructions of how to change it all. Extra stuff on here what you get is you can have like side skirts, which I like, so I'm going to keep that on there, especially with like the little V8 logo on there. You also have an option of up, what the fuck are they called? Upright exhaust or stacked exhausts. So we'll just go for like that. Really, if you had, actually, if we do that, then if we go there, and then go for a fixed body. Yeah, because in reality, you wouldn't have this giant exhaust up here with a material on the side. You'd have something solid, because it would fucking overheat and melt. Actually, would you? No, I've seen trucks of that before and haven't melted. Let's go with that. Yeah, fuck it. Right. I'm gonna keep this truck at the end of the episode. A bit of chrome. I'll leave that as that. Why aren't they gonna fit? They never got fitted with the stock ones. I like I on the Scanias anyway, I prefer the stock ones over the rest because they've got nice lights built into them. Mirror, I prefer a long one. Hehe, bit of chrome. Do that in a second. What we got? Oh, what's that one? Some lights. Let's bung some lights on. I prefer the rectangular ones. Boom, boom, boom. I want you in my room. Underbar. I like that one. Orange on the outside. I'm pretty sure it's illegal to have orange on the outside, so that one. That's the outside. Orange, white, 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 and white. Yep. Roof bars. Should we go for a roof bar? Go for a little roof bar one. That's something I thought that something that SES could do was come with like pre-built roof bars. You could have like a drop-down menu saying like pre-selected, pre-designed roof bars for different trucks. That's an idea. And interior accessories. Don't really want. Oh, there's a new cabin DLC. As of when this video goes out, I don't have it. I have had a bit of an issue with money recently. Well, not really a big issue. It's I've had my car insurance go out recently, and that's a big killer. And I can't even afford the for 3 quid that the DLC costs. I just can't. Oh shit! No, don't do that. I just can't risk having that money go out and then, yeah, and then being in the shit with it. So as soon as payday comes around, I'll get it and then I'll do another video on it, or I'll include it into another like a vlog video that we've been that look the theme of what we do is. Right, so that's everything. Right, confirm. Look at that beast. That mirror on the front there, that bothers me because I'm sure that should stick out more. Hey ho, right. Purchase. Do you want driving a truck? Of course we fucking do. So let's put the Merc. Oh, I can't remember where anything is. Let's just bung it in. Is that Rotterdam? Yeah, let's bung it in Rotterdam. So we should be in Estonia, which works well. We'll take you out on your guys right in Rotterdam right away. Lovely jubbly. Right, so are we in? Come on, world, load up. We're in. Right, yeah, we're in Tallinn. Lovely. Right, let's just have a quick look at the framework. I drove to Tallinn, got this place, and I really like the look of Tallinn because that felt like an Eastern European city, which is quite nice. This is the downside to the tandem mod. Shut up, phone. Why are you buzzing at me? I've got to be careful because I'm on standby to give a lift to give my brother and his missus a lift to the hospital because I might have a new nephew soon, which is very nice. So okay, so I've got set bladder. Oh, I can read that later. Snooze, by the way. Right, I'm blabbering. Yeah, it's got like a from what you see on like YouTube and that and pictures, it looks like a good European city. We'll have a look when we pull out of here. So I don't want to go too far because I'm a bit limited on time today. Ooh, yeah, I am. Right, so if we go somewhere short, we can go from in Tallinn to somewhere quite close. And that one looks quite good, actually. That's quite a ski little road. Is that through like mountains and stuff? Let's go. Plus a 24 ton, so be a good trial. Oh yeah, the one bad side to it is that all the trailers. There's no standard trailers. Everything is for the tandem one. Everything gets transformed into the tandem trailer. So even if you switch, if I kept that Merc and come out into this into the game, then all the trailers would still be tandem trailers and they wouldn't work. So you'd have to go out, disable the tandem mod, and then come back in, and then the trailers should hopefully be changed over. There was once where it didn't, and I got a bit worried. But yeah. So that's one bad side to it. Right, now isn't my steering wheel gonna work? Because you've been a bit of a dick recently as well. Yep, steering wheel's working, 1-to-1. Start this baby up. Get rid of that shit. Stick it in gear. Let's pull away. So we can have a look out the window and have a look at this bad boy. That sounds rough. So, the lift axle all works as you'd expect. I think there's also a steered axle. I think this one should be a steered axle as well. Yeah, very good. It's a steered axle as well. The body has lights on it as well, so we can switch the lights on the body. You got one in the side skirt as well, front side lights, got rear ones, brake lights all work as well. I say that, but I ain't got the ignition on. Yeah, brake lights all work, got brake lights at the top, reverse lights at the top, and then on the bottom, and like work lights as well. Yeah, it's all good. Right. This is a heavy fucker. It's probably in third gear. Let's just go. Yeah. The frame rate in these cities is not perfect. But then there's quite a lot of detail to render in. Oh. This is one thing I did miss from the single player was the traffic. You don't get that in the multiplayer. I need to try and muscle my way out. Oh, Mr. Persia, let me out. You know what? Okay. Just stopped. So, if you. That's a fucking joke. Come on then, come on. So just looking at it, it's already starting to look a bit like Eastern European. Come on. Just get those stand-up signs over there. Which is, you just don't get them in the UK. Come on. I am waiting. Da-da-da-da-da. Oh, we got the dash on this one. Right pressure to left, sorry. Let's leave it on that for a bit, just have a look at that. Right, come on! Turn my axle up. Right. That's one thing I want to test on here is with the new lift axle. Is do you get more vehicle damage as you go along? So like, I know you get vehicle damage by just going along anyway. That's like trying to stand up here, right? There we go. I know you get like general vehicle damage as you go along. That's just like, so that's to like force you to have service or such. Which way are you going, fella? You going there? Okay, good. Oh, look, the sound this game makes. But I want to know if with the new axle configurations, the ones that you can lift up, does it, if you lift it up, does it then slow down the vehicle damage? That's the whole idea of a lift axle, is why use an axle if you don't need to use it? So we're speeding about 30. Fuck, I'm just gonna cruise control set to be 40 miles an hour. Let's go 30. So it would be interesting to know if that does actually affect, if they have put that into the game. How far away is this trail? 1 mile. As you can see, I haven't explored all the town yet. Where am I going to? Where have I put them? I want to show you guys. Dickhead! I've been trying with some other mods as well. I did put in Oh, hold on. Yeah, these train tracks. Someone can let me know if these are actual active tracks, because I have no idea. I haven't seen anything on them. I don't want to park on them and then find out I get fucking rammed by a train. Yeah, I've tried other mods. I've tried with, I tried like a Peterbilt. Actually, yeah, I tried with a Peterbilt and like the big American trucks. And for some reason, I just can't get them to work, even though they're compatible with 1.21 or 1.20, whichever we're on now. I just can't get them to work. I even tried a Peugeot boxer van to try and change things up a bit. I couldn't get them to work. The only ones I've been able to get it to work is this tandem mod and the pro mods. I haven't tried any other map ones, there's not too interesting in the map ones. Got too much map to fucking work with already. I'm also picking up from WGC. I think I'm picking up from in here. I don't know. Was it this one? There it is, cement. I'm gonna fucking have cement in a fucking cool trailer, I don't know. So I don't know how picking up a trailer is gonna work here. Because all this map is designed for semi-trailers. So the distance in between objects and the trailer is different. Because we've got a bigger unit here, a bigger tractor unit. Right, so I have to use the mirrors. I'm going to see how that mirror, that window anyway. I might be able to pick it up as it is. Like this. There we go. Right, so there we go. The suspension's just taken hold and the whole thing's just gone fucking all over the place. Let's knock out a gear, put a park brake on. And if we go, can they get loud? If we go here, You can see the arse end has dropped. The actual front wheels are off the fucking floor, look. Yeah, so it's a big bow in the middle where the actual weight's taken on the back of the truck. So now if we look, drop the rear axle. That brings it down. I don't think it's bringing it down as much as it should do though. Steering doesn't feel light. It's drooped in the middle. It's a little bit drooped. Maybe we've overdone the trailer weight with this. Oh well, let's have a look, let's see what happens. Right, we're off. So we've actually got a four axle trailer on, so that's quite a heavy duty trailer anyway. Right, so how long is our journey? It's a 6 hour journey, but there's a ferry journey as well in that. I wanted to change this up because I was getting a bit, I'm not bored of it, but I wanted to try another driving challenge. So if you're just constantly driving the same truck, parking up the same trailers, you can sometimes get a little bit bored. Right, now I'm trying to squeeze myself out. Sorry, I'm gonna have to cut you guys up. Oh, thanks, sir. Thank you very much. Let's head up monster. This is a whole huge unit. It's easy to drive. I haven't driven one on the road because I've still got a license to be able to do that. But I have driven. I drive rigid trucks, which is what this is. And I've reversed ones with trailers. And draw by trailer is a lot easier to reverse than what a semi-trailer is, because you're working on a pivot that you can. It's hard to explain, really. Oh shit! Curb. Sorry. Yeah, the pivot, basically the pivot's different, and it's just an easier way of parking it. If you get this mod, let me know how you feel about it. See if you find it easier. It's a little bit harder in game because you're so used to reversing normal trailers or semi-trailers, whichever you want to call them. And it's a little bit difficult to get used to it. But in real life, I prefer drawbar trailers. Now the thingy. Oh no, yeah, this one, yeah. They've modified it a bit. You have to go right through. These poles don't exist, you can drive right through them, I think. I won't take the risk. Pull them round, and you pull onto the boat. On we go. Off port Finland. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna do another video when we go off to when we go off to Reykjavik. I have to do a Reykjavik one. From what I've heard, Reykjavik is quite a beautiful country. It's a bit barren, but it's beautiful. And I'm one for the sights, I am. Right, so how long should I have to go? 6 hours. Oh, let's just change. 0 miles, 0 minutes. What? Better change my hit now. Hold on. 4 hours, that's not too far. Right, off onto the road again we go. There's some ferries that which ones they are, but the ones where they've got like the security gate. You gotta be careful because if you have a big cab with a what the fuck am I trying to say? With a big body on it, you'll hit the thing. I hit it at like fucking 30 miles an hour and it destroyed my truck. But yeah, this is Helsinki, I think. So it's a beautiful looking city. Unfortunately, we only get a quick look at it, but I've driven all the way around it and it's got cobbled roads and old buildings like we see along the side here. It's a beautiful city. So why this truck is put on well. So this is 50, but I know we can do. Got to 60 anyway because the speed cameras work on the speed limit on the road for a car, so you can go that fast. It's illegal, it's wrong, but you can do it. Might miss a tier as well. I don't know why the buttons along the bottom there are lit up. I don't know if they are in real life. This truck also feels top heavy, which you'd expect. So when you're turning, the whole cab does move a lot more, and I'm pretty sure it does move a lot more than what the standard tractor units do. But yeah, what other things have I got to say then? Yeah, this video should be out on a Saturday. It should be out on Saturday, I can't remember what the date is. 10th, I think. Yeah, 10th. It should be on the 10th. So it's the Life is Strange. I'm gonna move to a weekly thing. Episode 4 will be out all next week. Every day next week, so I'll get the last few episodes out before the episode 5, the finale comes out on the 20th. I'll get all them done, and then I can record 5 and then get them out. I'm gonna try and keep up to date with them ones and get them out ASAP. I've been fucking slow as fuck with them. It's been annoying. Shouldn't there be a speed limit here? There is, 31. No speed cameras, so let's just take it nice and slow. Back up to speed? Yeah, 50 miles an hour, so yeah. So it's Eurotruck Movement of Saturday. I'm gonna get all of Life is Strange out. Then we do episode 5. I'm gonna record Formula 1 Race 2 tomorrow. So today's the 10th, no, it's the 8th today. What the fuck does that bling? Something in my ear holes and bling, you might hear on the report. I don't know, I have to check. Fuck knows what that was. Yeah, whatever. I don't know what the hell that was. This Windows 10, man, it's fucking all sorts of new noises. What the fuck was I saying? You get distracted. Yeah, I'm gonna record Formula Race 2 tomorrow. I don't know what Race 2 is, I think it's Dubai. I can't remember. Yeah, Race 2 tomorrow, so that'll be out. I think it's gonna be out Wednesday next week, so it won't be a Life is Strange video on Wednesday, but it will be every other day. That's the only day I'm gonna try and get Formula 1 out and out of the way. A pointless broadcaster thing. I said in the last video, yeah, I'm joining up with a load of other guys to make some more videos. But that deal sort of fell through. There was a bit of creative differences, which is rather annoying because I was looking forward to recording with guys on Farmers Simulator, because one of the guys there, Massey, who's fucking, he knows his stuff on. Shit, the fucking frame rate's really taking a hit here. It's like how it used to play it, fuck's sake. What are you doing? Sort out. Yeah, it's going up now. That's not. No, you got 20. That's a bit of a dead zone there. Yeah, he really knew his shit, and that was good to play with him and learn from him. Unfortunately, that the deal fell through, and unfortunately, it sadly got sour, and I've not spoke to any of the guys from Portland's Broadcaster since the deal fell through. Which, very sad, very sad. But I am looking forward to the future, and I've got to decide what I'm going to do. I've had an offer from another guy to work with him. Excuse me, I need a drink. To work with him and work on his YouTube channel and do videos for him. And he promotes me, and we do collaborations. You know, it's got a big deal. I'm going this guy just for a little while. We haven't really spoke too much, but I've known him through Massey, and I've been a part of his group, the VTC or gaming community, whatever you call it, in before. It's called Red Vault Gaming. Look them up on YouTube, look them up on Facebook, Twitter and all that. They are on there. They're not really active, but I want to come into it and not take over, but I want to get all that side active again, because that's all that stuff has worked for my channel. So I want to get it to work for his and try and get that one up and running as well. But yeah, the two channels can work together. Like I said before, when I was looking at when I was doing Pointless Broadcaster, this channel is still my main priority, always will be. Fuck, that was a bit tight. But I'm gonna dedicate a bit of my time to Red Vault. Shit, this handles like a bastard. Yeah, dedicate a bit of my time to Red Vault to try and get that going as well, because that has, although it hasn't got many views on its on its YouTube channel, on its YouTube videos, that is a quite a big Twitch streamer. And if we can get the two combined, the YouTube channel and the Twitch channel, and get my channel involved in there somewhere as well, I've got access to, you know, countless amounts of viewers like RVG has. I can also bring some of my viewers over, because I don't want to be big headed, but my Eurotruck video has been a bit more successful than what his has on his channel. Whether they're actually any better than what he has produced, than what he has produced, and what his gaming community has produced, I don't know. But I can. I think I can bring something to the RPG. I'm in truck struggling now. Come on, Betsy. So yeah, that's how it's going to be going forward. Any video that I put up onto RPG, I need to still have a discussion with, his name's AK. I need to have a discussion with him about what the finer details are going to be, but one thing I want to do is, if I put a video up onto his, I want to share onto my channel so you guys still have access to it. What is that guy on the left doing? Come on! I do still want to look into getting into Farm Simulator 2015 as well, because I've got to be careful, because I'm not because I got a load of mods off it was off Massey for when we were doing Pointless Broadcasting, but there's a load of mods in there that were private mods, and I'm not too sure whether I can put them onto, you know, put them into a video, because of, you know, copyright and all that. I'm not too sure where I stand on that. But I know the map. I really want to show off the map. What's this dickhead on the left doing? I'm about to go faster than you. Ha! Fuck off, Mr. Volvo. The map I know I can show, because that is not, I'm pretty sure it's not modified in any way, so I can show that. But when and how and what I want to do with it, I don't know, because I don't know whether I've got the time to do these longer Eurotruck videos and do that do quite long farming simulator videos as well, which they are quite time-consuming videos to be able to do farming. So I don't know. Let me know what you guys want, if that idea appeals to you guys. What's going on here? Whoa! Dickhead, what the hell are you doing? Yeah, back it up, Sunshine. Don't you pull out on me. Okay. Come on. Keep it going. Keep her going. Yeah, let me know, guys, in the comments what you want to see. If you want to see a Farmer Simulator 2015, I'll bring it in and I'll show that map off to you guys. Really good map, I really like it. But then there's mods as well. If you just want to get, like, if you guys want to see like specific mods, I'll, you know, I'll bring them in. I'm not too clued up on Farm Simulator, but I know enough of it to be able to show stuff off. Oh, nearly there, that's good. That's right. Pull over to this lane. Oh, that fucking tunnel cuts me out. Da-da-da. Yeah, it's not been a very scenic route, has it? Sorry if I just saw that little edit there. And a little toilet. Professionalism! Yeah, this hasn't been really seen it much, has it? So I'm gonna check on the map where we are. Oh, so we've already gone through all that what I thought would be scenic route. And the hell do we go? Do we go over a bridge? Do we go next to some water? I was not paying much attention. I'm calling this, we're about to come over another bridge. Don't think we are we? Scenery struggles to pop itself in, take this time. I usually do that. Slow down again. This guy's about to dick me over. Bastard. Another thing I want to hear from you guys is if any of you guys who watch this have got the. Hey, you're not cutting it now, bastards. Ooh, shit. Have got the. The Logitech G29. No, I don't want to go that way. What am I doing? The Logitech G29 steering wheel, you know, the latest one. Basically, the new one for the PS4 and that. I just want to know what your experiences with it, guys, are. I don't have a G27. I know that the steering wheel is based on the G29 is based on a G27, but it's been modified for PS4. I just want to know you guys think of it. Is it worth the buy? Oh, now we're going over a bridge. Because I'm stuck with a, do I get a G27, which I know is a solid steering wheel, which will work, which everyone, oh shit, my mouse just moved, which everyone, you know, raves. But is the G29 just as good or better? Stuck on what to get, so let me know, guys, what you think, and then I will get accordingly once I get money, obviously. Oh, there we go, I've got a message now. Better check that actually, make sure it's not proper. Oh, on my phone, was driving, highly legal, but hey ho. Hopefully, misses something. Check over there. Something I was expecting to come to fruition whilst I was away from YouTube was, it was two lanes in. Sorry. was American Truck. That was supposed to be out. Well, I don't know. There's no fixed date for it, but it was highly expected to be out fucking far earlier than what it is gonna be. At the moment, we haven't seen a full. We've seen like a alpha or beta gameplay footage from SES themselves. We ain't seen nothing solid yet. I like busy seas on Eurotruck. It's more realistic. Straight ahead, isn't it? Then, yeah. Oh, it's gonna be an easy park. I'm just gonna show you. Yeah, there's still no fixed date for American Truck. Hope it's gonna be soon. Right, so you can't do what you normally do on this, so you gotta sort of straighten it up as such. You can't, it's not as easy to come at it from an angle. So right. So the thing about this is when you back it up, you can't overdo it because you have. Because when you bring it round, the rear of the trailer brings itself in line and such, like you saw there, where the other trailers don't do that, because you're pivoting on the axle rather than you pivot at a different point. It's fucking hard to explain it. Scientific angles and maths and shit. My pulse is parking up in front of the ship, so I think I'll let me have it anyway. There we go. So yeah, and you can just saw just then a second ago the fucking axle shot up as well, so weight is definitely a thing. King of the road. I thought I normally or did I not was that not a bonus one? Proficiency bonus. I want a bonus. So yeah, that's that. Shit. So yeah, pull that away. Get the axle up. Put the fire brake on. Job's a bit. Why are my lights? I'm watching the side lights. Watching the side lights. But yeah, so that is that. Yeah, like I say, Eurotruck. It's going every single bit loud. Like I say, Eurotruck will be back on the Saturday. I'm going to try my very best to get out every Saturday. Like I was doing, but I can't promise any of them. I'm only restricted to 2 days worth of recording at the moment, where I had five before, so we'll see how that goes. But yeah, that's that. I'll try and put the mod links in the description below for pro mods and the tandem mod. Like I said, I'll just try and find them where they are again to put the proper link. But yeah, they're worth getting if you like the look of them. But yeah, so guys, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you soon. Bye bye.